So, my town has two really great restaurants, Uncle Vito's Pizza Palace and the House of International Cuisine. Both are awesome, with really good food. The House of International Cuisine is great for those times when you have a big group of people who are all craving different things. And yeah, they have pizza too. After all, it's a house of international cuisine. But the pizza at Uncle Vito's, it just hits a little different. The crust is like a perfect balance of chewy and crunchy. The sauce is out of this world. Oh, and they use the freshest cheese possible. If you're in town and craving pizza, you have to go to Uncle Vito's. Pizza is their specialty. Hey there! Today, we're going to be talking about specialization, an important concept related to production. By the end of today's lesson, you should be able to answer the following. What is specialization? What factors lead to specialization? What are the effects of specialization? You should also start considering our big picture question, why is it important to seek advantages in an economy? Now, Uncle Vito's Pizza Palace and House of International Cuisine present two different production philosophies. The House of International Cuisine has a wide and varied menu. Economists would call this diversification, which means that individuals or firms are producing multiple types of goods or services. Uncle Vito's Pizza Palace only does pizza. No sandwiches. No chicken wings. Just pizza. And because pizza is the only thing that Uncle Vito's does, they're really productive at making it. And if there is one thing that economists love, it's maximizing productivity. So economists advocate for specialization. Specialization means focusing on a particular good or service in which an individual or firm has an advantage. And while businesses like Uncle Vito's Pizza Palace specialize in a particular good, countries can specialize too. In the PDF activity for this lesson, we're going to examine how one nation has turned specializing in oil production into a highly profitable venture. All right, let's check in here for just a second. Say one of your friends is having difficulty grasping what specialization is. How would you explain it to them? It's important to recognize that there are several factors that lead to specialization. Remember when we talked in Unit 1 about how availability and quality of resources had a huge impact on production? Well, that applies to specialization as well. Uncle Vito's cousin makes top quality fresh mozzarella cheese that Uncle Vito uses for his pizza. This connection and access to cheese gives Uncle Vito an advantage in producing pizza. Specialization also occurs because a producer develops expertise and technical experience in producing a good. Take Uncle Vito as an example. He's worked in pizza restaurants since he was a teenager. He has taken everything that he's learned in all of those years to make his restaurant one of the best pizza restaurants around. Other firms specialize in a product because they see an opportunity to provide a good or service. For example, before Uncle Vito opened up his restaurant, people had to drive 45 minutes to the nearest pizza place. Take a second to think about your town. What are some examples of businesses that specialize in a good or service that you've seen? Now that we've talked about some of the factors that lead businesses to specialize, let's put our knowledge into practice. Why would a chef think about opening a sandwich truck and taking it to a crowded office park that didn't have any restaurants nearby? So, we've talked about what specialization is and what causes it. Now, the biggest question yet. What's the big deal with specialization anyway? Well, you know that specialization makes firms more efficient and productive at producing a good or service. That efficiency leads to what is known as economies of scale. Economies of scale is the principle that as a firm produces more of a good, it becomes less expensive to produce each individual unit of that good. This means that the marginal cost of making that good decreases. You may have seen this principle in action and not even known it. Think about a custom t-shirt. If you buy just one, it may cost you $15. If you and four of your friends order the same shirt, it may cost $12 a shirt. If all 200 members of the senior class of the local high school want that t-shirt, it'll cost $8 a shirt. How does that work? Some costs, like designing and creating the pattern, the cost to operate the machinery, and even the cost of rent get spread out over more t-shirts. That means that each shirt in a larger order costs less to make, meaning they can be sold for less and still be profitable. And so the t-shirt maker sets these prices in order to encourage larger orders. So increased efficiency and productivity allows firms to increase revenues while lowering costs, leading to... That's right, more profit. For consumers, it leads to a lower-priced item. Focusing on producing a specific good or service also fosters innovation. With producers motivated to profit from their businesses, they might find a new process to produce the good or service, or identify a new feature that benefits customers. Uncle Vito was looking to increase sales by making the pizza ordering process easier. He implemented a smartphone app where customers could order a pizza, pay for it, and have it ready for pickup or delivery. As this app took off, Uncle Vito's was able to sell more pizzas. And because there was less time spent talking to customers on the phone, the pizzas got made faster. Specialization also allows firms to produce a better product. Because Uncle Vito's Pizza Palace focuses on making pizza, they are more likely to turn out a better pizza than the House of International Cuisine, which has to try to make a lot of different types of food at any given time. Specialization also allows for increased trade. That custom t-shirt company wants to cater a pizza lunch for employees, and Uncle Vito's Pizza Palace needs new uniforms. They might work out a deal so that both businesses benefit. I mean, it wouldn't really make sense for the t-shirt company to try and make their own pizzas. But specialization also poses a risk, too. As businesses and nations become increasingly specialized, any sort of disruption to resources can have a huge impact. Imagine what would happen to Uncle Vito's Pizza Palace if there was a shortage of tomatoes that went into the pizza sauce. The restaurant might not be able to survive if it can't make pizza. All right, let's take a moment to try and apply what we've learned. Your friend Joe is trying to decide if they should just mow lawns this summer or if they should also offer pet walking and babysitting services as well. What are potential advantages and disadvantages to specializing in mowing lawns? Okay, let's take a moment to recap. Many businesses choose to focus on a good or service that they have an advantage producing, a process known as specialization. Individuals and firms can specialize if they have access to certain resources, have experience or technical expertise in producing a good, or they see an opportunity to provide a new good or service. Specialization allows individuals, firms, and countries to produce a good more efficiently, which is beneficial to both producers and consumers. It also encourages trade and innovation. But disruptions to resources and supplies can have significant negative impacts to businesses that specialize in a single good or service. In the next few lessons, we are going to examine different ways to determine whether we should specialize in producing a single good or service, and what that good or service should be. Until then, remember to keep investing in yourself one lesson at a time. I'll see you next time. Hey!